No, I don't know what to do. I'm getting hornier, but like my body's falling apart. Fuck. I was like, I have rheumatoid arthritis now, which is very dismissed as an illness because it has arthritis in it. So people go like, yeah, my grandma's back hurts when it rains. And you're like, no, like my body, like what MS does to nerve endings, if you're familiar with MS at all, rheumatoid arthritis does to joints. So I'm whittling down and turning into a, thank you for clapping, because I won't be able to much longer. Just turning into a human Joshua tree, right? Which is fun in Los Angeles, because I have girlfriends who will be like, have you tried just carrying a crystal? Maybe put some jade in your bra. You want me to carry a rock when I'm turning into a rock? That's your... I will beat you over the head with a crystal, Ashley. What in the fuck are you talking... I still do it, though. I've got it. I'm loaded up here. Just any. I'll try anything. Right? Just fucking... That's fun. That's funny. That's like, the universe will provide what you need. A lot of people like that. A lot of people like that that I'm friends with. And you have to go, oh, universe, is that what you call your dad's credit card? Is that what... The universe, yeah. The secret, it'll work out. Yeah, for you. You have a trust fund. No, but I have rheumatoid arthritis, so it's like I'm getting hornier, I'm trying to fuck, and then my body's falling apart because I'm trying to embrace my sexuality. You know what? I'm not afraid of it. Yeah. But then, like, sometimes I'll be on top of a guy and my hips and my knees lock up, and I have to be like, ah, I hit the button, and the guy under me is always like, you're clit, and I have to be like, no, my life alert. Like, I'm just... I'm trying to own it, so I'm like, let's fuck, my knee. I gotta take a painkiller. Here's what I'm gonna take a painkiller. You see if you can make me come before I pass out, huh? No, it's fine, I'm consenting. No, I'm literally asking for it. Yes. You're not gonna deny a dying woman her wish, are you? Which nothing gives a guy a harder dick than you being like, please, it might be my last time around the sun. They're like, oh yeah. Like, doggy style used to be a challenge purely from an arm strength perspective, right? Like, every woman in here who's done it doggy style knows what I'm talking about, where you're like, unless you're a gymnast, you've got like 1.5, maybe 2 minutes before you start at least sweating. You're like, oh God, I hope it fucking ends soon. You're just hoping he comes before you have to go from full plank to half plank. You're like, come on. Just focus. Like, thank God he can't see me. You're like, oh yeah, oh, it feels so good. And then it's like, that's a position where like guys usually come pretty quickly. So if it goes a little too long, I get in my head. I'm like, oh no, my pussy's gone bad. They're gonna send me out to sea. I'm donezo. What is that? That I think it's like the 1200s. Like, we don't like our pussy. Just put her out on a farm. She'll be fine. But so then it's like, I'll like try to clinch. I do the clinch thing to try to make my pussy tighter, but then like my ass is already so flat. And then I clinch and it looks like my butt's like, my asshole's like sucking in my butt cheeks. And that's not gonna make a guy come harder. So then I'm trying to like stick out my butt, but like you can't do both at the same time. You can't clinch and stick it out. So then I just start curving and I'm like, oh, do you like that? Do you like how it looks like I have scoliosis? Is that good for you? And by the way, nobody I'm fucking is an athlete. Like, my boyfriend now, he's got a dad bod. So it's like, it's fucked. Because I'm reliving those moments like the glory days. Because right now, if I get fucked from behind, I got 10 seconds before every joint just collapses. I faceplant. Just like, motherfucker. And guys don't stop fucking you when you collapse during doggy style. Nothing could be better for a man. He's like, I did that with my dick. Yeah, my big dick did that. You like that? Like, his dick could be this, like, the size of my pinky. And he's like, oh, yeah, I did that. And you're down there like, please stop. And he's like, did you say that you love my cock? And so it's like, now my boyfriend, who's not an athlete, has lost me as a crutch to hold him up. So his arms start getting weak, and his, like, hairy dad bod is now mushing into my back fat. It's creating a weird sweat pool, just like... You know, making that like tanning bed salon fart noise, you know? Just, and I'm trapped under him going like, is that my back or my pussy? I don't know. Which is not a fun place to be as a lady. Because as a woman, you queef and the instinct is, well, I have to leave the planet now. Call my pussy Doge, boys. We're going to the moon. You rarely hear of a woman abandoning her family. But what I think happens, anytime that's a scenario, this is what I think happens. Kids are tucked in bed, sleeping away, and mom's like, time to make love. And then she queefs, and she's like, my family will be better off without me. I'm moving to West Virginia to start a new life. I'm gonna get into marketing. She gets on a motorcycle. It doesn't even have an engine. She just queefs across the country. Just...